When you finally land that monster trout, it's time to take that rewarding photo and then release the fish back into the water so others can enjoy the thrill that you just experienced. This lesson will go over proper ways to handle trout and then release them. When you hook into a fish, try not to overexhaust it. Try to reduce the amount of stress the fish incurs by bringing it in as quickly as possible. As soon as you get to the trout close enough, a good net, which we discussed in previous lessons, will come in extremely handy. I recommend a rubber net versus a mesh one. Rubber nets are great. Flies don't get tangled up in them, and they're less abrasive on a fish's gills when you scoop that bad boy in. As soon as the fish is close enough to you for you to scoop it in your net, make sure to wet your hands before placing them in the water. Fish have a layer of mucus that protects them from diseases. Contact with dry surfaces such as your hands, a dry net, boat bottoms, land, all of this can remove that slime and make a fish more susceptible to disease. So if you don't have a net, make sure you wet your hands before handling a fish. Place the net in the water behind the fish and scoop forward as you bring its head to the surface. After you have the fish in your net, keep the net in the water. This will keep the fish well oxygenated while you prepare to take out the hook. Congratulations, you've landed a monster. Now take a moment and enjoy it. These are amazing creatures, and after all your hard work, you should take it all in. After you've had your moment of glory, now it's time to make sure that there's evidence of your adventures. Let's start by removing the fly. Make sure that you grip the trout very carefully. Fish have very sensitive internal organs, so hold it lightly without squeezing. Avoid placing your hands over its mouth or gills, as this would obstruct breathing. With larger fish, grip the tail with an A-OK finger formation and gently support the body under the front fins. Make sure you're carrying easily accessible pliers or any other type of hook removal tool that you might have picked up. This will help you have a quick and careful hook removal. Now take your pliers and locate the fly in the fish's mouth. Grip the fly with the pliers and push and pull in the opposite direction of the hook. Your fly should pop right out. Now that you've removed that fly, it's time to take a photograph of that monster. When at all possible, photograph the fish in the water. If you want to get the quintessential trophy picture, start by keeping it as close to the surface as possible and fully submerged. When you're ready, let the photographer call the shots. Have him say 1, 2, 3, then you can raise the fish out of the water, take the picture quickly, and then get the fish back in the water as fast as possible. Dunk the fish after each shot. This will give him a quick breather before you move on to capture that perfect one to hang on your wall. Just like humans, fish experience exercise-induced stress. In order to recover from being caught, fish need to be in the water so they can breathe and pump oxygen into their system. You can reduce these health effects by keeping a fish's mouth and gills fully submerged in the water as much as possible during the handling process. After all the excitement, not only for you but for the fish might be exhausted and need a little reviving. This can be done in the water by submerging the fish and holding its head facing upstream so that the water runs into its mouth and through the gills. In still water situations, move the fish in a figure 8 pattern to stimulate this effect. Avoid pulling the fish backwards or pointing it downstream, as water moving in the reverse direction can harm the fish. Most of the time, the trout's going to let you know when he's ready to go. But if he's just hanging around, it's probably because he has to catch his breath. Let it relax for a little bit and give it a gentle touch on the tail, and most likely it'll be on its way. Thank you.